The metrics that we look at when we evaluate a subwoofer are five of them. First is how low the subwoofer can go. Secondly is how loud it can play. And then thirdly is frequency response, how flat it is. Fourth is distortion, how distorted it can get. And last and not least is how tight the bass sounds. So how low the subwoofer can go. Most subwoofers are designed to go down to maybe 25 Hertz. What we call the true subwoofers are the one that goes down below that. So for people that love organ music, ideally you want the subwoofer to go down to 16 Hertz. And also these days a lot of movies also have deep bass going down to that low. So 16 Hertz is usually a good target to aim for. How loud the subwoofer can play, this is called the sound pressure level that the subwoofer can achieve. This is usually measured in decibels, dB for short. And this is particularly important for home theater, where you want to feel the rumble. So the higher the SPL or the dB the subwoofer can achieve, the better it would be. And this also is a question of how loud it can play at different frequencies. This ties into the number one point, how low it can go. The third is the frequency response. This is a measure of how loud it plays at different frequencies. And the flatter it is, the more accurate it is in terms of reproducing what the input signal is. This one is kind of complicated in the sense that the frequency response can vary with the loudness that you're playing it at. But at least at a normal, say 80-90 dB sound pressure level, then we want the frequency response to be at least pretty flat down to the lowest frequency you would like to hear. Distortion is a problem when you can hear it. When it comes to distortion, what it generally means is that it is deviation from the original. So there are different types of distortion: dynamic distortion, harmonic distortion, and intermodulation distortion. So in general, as long as it's not very obvious, it should be okay, but you want it to be as low as possible. Last is bass tightness. This is a qualitative assessment of it. Means in general, what you want the bass to do is that the moment the signal stops, you want to have the subwoofer, the audible sound, to stop also. So you don't want the bass notes to hang on after the actual bass hit has stopped. So that's what they call bass tightness. Conclusion, these are the factors that you should look at when you are evaluating which subwoofer to get. And these also happens to be the metrics that we take into full consideration in the design of all our subwoofers.